on the subject of religion, I wanted to, I might as well go ahead a little a little bit and say that, you know, not only did I, I'm publishing this book, and I'm thinking that that people are mostly going to say that Knuth is off his rocker because he's publishing a book about the Bible, and he's what he does well is computer science. What's, you know, are we going to be able to trust him anymore, and so on? But the reaction was, to my face anyway, was quite the opposite. And a lot of people seemed to like the book. And the most surprising thing was at the in 1999, or actually it was a year earlier, when I got a letter from MIT inviting me to give a series of lectures about science and religion. And well, this is something I'm obviously unqualified to do, but it was hard to just turn down the letter and say, forget it, because, well, it was sort of something that I thought about a lot during my life, and I thought maybe some of the experiences I had could be relevant to other people who are wrestling with the same things in their minds. And if I was never going to talk about these things in my life, that was one thing, or would I feel incomplete if I didn't do something about it? On the other hand, I certainly don't want this to be my career, where I'm you know, not going out on a religious circuit or something. So on balance, I figured, okay, let's think of it as a win-win situation. I'll go and hope that the force is with me and I can say something of interest to people. And if I was ever going to do it one-off and once in my life, where could I, where better than in Boston, where I had spent most of the time in the library looking at these theological works, and where I got an audience at MIT, you know, ideal place to have to make an influence, if there's any such place. But they had asked me to give six public lectures, a series of six public lectures, an hour and a half each, and that's you know, I have some standards where I didn't know if I had that much to say, obviously. So I decided, okay, what I'll do is I will prepare only half of these lectures, and the other half will be Q&A. Will be just improvised responses to what the audience says. And if it doesn't go well, so what? I tried, I did it, and it's over with. And if people you know, think it's valuable, then that's so much the better. But I wouldn't mind spending a few months in Boston again, being a nice place to be. And I had some things I wanted to look up also in the libraries while I was there. So. So I said yes, and I went then in the fall for 3 months in at the end of 1999 to relearn the Boston experience. This time I didn't live in Back Bay. I lived near Harvard Square, across the street from the Observatory, and I took my bike every morning along the Charles River to MIT, and made a lot of friends there that I, you know, younger people that I hadn't known before, doing computer science. And then I gave my six public lectures and a couple others too, about computer eye design and things like that, other projects that were going on. And I got to you know, to also go to New York City a few times, and I visited Will Shortz and was able to, you know, make use of being in the East. But here I am in Boston, giving these public lectures. The night, let's see, I think my first lecture, I was competing with Jesse Ventura, who was also giving a lecture in Boston that same day, but I still had standing room only in this hall of about 400 people. It's not that big a hall, but it was amazing to me. And they And they came back the second week as well. And we had, the lectures were sort of in the late afternoon, three or four times, and then a pause, and then another three, four times at weekly intervals. So in these lectures, I didn't present the answers to any of the deep problems. I just said, well, look, I think computer science is wonderful, but it's not everything in life, and so there is other things that deserve attention, and some of the paradoxes that I was confronted with, how did they affect me, and sort of asking the audience, maybe next time it's their turn to give a lecture, focus group or something. No, it was more just like saying, let's for once in our life talk about things that aren't our subject of expertise, but just how we balance these issues. And I had great comments from the audience, and great so it was very stimulating to do these question and answer sessions. And I also learned a lot from the people that I met there, because there were people from many different backgrounds. It was again kind of a plus thing, but certainly nothing that I wanted to do for the rest of my life. I've got to focus on the art of computer programming. That's where I can do something unique.